So today I want to tell you about the pancake number, which is among the most ridiculously named numbers in maths, but it is technically to do with pancakes, or at least pancakes are one nice way to explain what this number is. We have a pan full of pancakes here, and the idea with this is they're not all the same size, so we have five different sizes of pancake, and we also have a very inconsiderate chef who makes pancakes all different sizes and then serves them up in the wrong order. Because I'm sure you'll agree, if you've got a stack of pancakes of all different sizes, the most satisfying way is to have them in decreasing order of size, with the smallest one at the top and the biggest one at the bottom. So we need to try and get this stack of pancakes back into order. So I'll stick it on a plate. I'll use my pancake flipper.
Safety first.
Yeah. So stick that on a plate. So the question now is, how do we put these pancakes back into the right order? There is a rule about how I'm allowed to shuffle these around. I'm allowed to take the top section of pancakes and turn it over, and that's all I can do. So in this case, what do I want to do? I want to flip maybe the whole thing? Yeah, I want to flip the whole thing. No, in fact, first I'm going to flip these top two, and the reason for that will become apparent shortly. So I do that. So that's one flip. And I'm now going to flip the whole thing. There we go. And now I'm going to flip. Oh, I shouldn't have flipped the top two. I'll figure this out eventually. So I'll flip those three. That's three flips. I now flip the whole thing again. That's four flips. And if I hadn't flipped those top two at the start, I would have had not to do this now, but never mind. So that's five flips, which is fine because I know that any stack of pancakes can be fixed in five or fewer flips. This one, I suspect, could have been in slightly fewer five, but in this case, I've used exactly five, which is within the bounds, so that's fine. So any stack of five pancakes can be done in five or fewer flips. There are obviously some that, well, this is currently in the state where it needs zero flips, but there are obviously some that can be done in fewer than five, and the most you will need for five pancakes, doing it in the most efficient possible way, is five. So the pancake number for five pancakes is therefore five. And this works for any number of pancakes in a stack. So I can show you what happens with three pancakes. There are six possible orderings for three pancakes. So I could have small, medium, large, three at the bottom again, but instead have two and then one. Two at the bottom, then three, then one, like that. One at the bottom and then two and then three. Two at the bottom, one, three, like that. And finally, one at the bottom, three, and then two. That gives me all six possible orderings. And for each one of these, I can work out how many flips I need to get it back into the sort of standard correct way up. So in this case, it's zero flips. It's already there. This can be done in one, which is just to flip the whole thing. This one can be done in one flip. This one, if I flip those top two and then flip the whole thing, I'll get back to sorted. So I'm going to call that one two flips. This one, if I flip the whole thing and then flip those top two around, that'll be two flips. And in this case, this is the most difficult one because this can't be done in fewer than three flips. So I can do it in three. I would maybe say flip the whole thing and then flip the top two and then flip the whole thing. But it can't be done in fewer than three. So for three pancakes, the pancake number is three.
I'm seeing a trend.
Yes, it does look a little bit patterny. So for three, it's three. For four, it's four. For five, it's five. After that, it starts to go on. So every so often, it goes up by two instead of going up by one. So it's not quite always just the number of pancakes that you've got. But it is actually something that people try and calculate. They try and work out what is the pancake number for a given number of pancakes. And it's actually an ongoing question, because for 20 pancakes, we don't know what the pancake number is.
No,
it's an open question in maths. We don't actually have 20 or above. We don't actually really know what the answer is to this. And I guess it's partly because it's just a massive computation. If you've got 20 pancakes in a stack, the number of possible ways you could order 20 pancakes in a stack is massive. For any given ordering, the number of possible sets of flips you could do is even massiver. You know, to check all of those and see which one is the most efficient would take a lot of computer time. So no one's managed to crack that yet.
What is it for 19?
For 19, it's 22, I think. Something like that. So yeah, we know it's more than 22. And in fact, we know it's less than, I think, 35. And the reason, the person that we have to credit with the fact that we know it's less than 35 is Bill Gates. So Bill Gates, the guy off of Microsoft, when he was at university in 1979, when he was 24, he did a paper. Unfortunately, the paper wasn't called like on the pancake number. It was called something like algorithms for prefix reversals. because that's the technical computer science term for this. If you're taking the first section and reversing it, that's a prefix reversal. And his paper, they proved that there is an upper bound for the pancake number. For if you know how many pancakes you've got, what the upper bound is for n pancakes. So I think for n pancakes, they proved that it's 5n plus 5 over 3, which means that for 20 pancakes, it's 105 over 3. That means it's 35. That is thanks to Bill Gates. Since then, they've actually worked out a better upper bound for it that's slightly nicer. They've now shown that anything is less than 18n over 11, which was found in 2009, which was exactly 40 years later. They managed to improve on that bound. So there is a way that will always work for any given kind of messed up stack of pancakes. So the trick is that you take whichever pancake is the biggest pancake that's not currently where it's supposed to be and put it to the top. And then I put that one to where it's meant to be. If you keep repeating that, so if now, say, if pancake 3 wasn't in the right place, you do the same thing, you put it to the top, and then each time you're kind of definitely going to place at least one pancake, possibly more if you're lucky. You will always do it in 2n minus 3, so for n pancakes. In the case of 5, it would always do it in 7 or fewer, but I know that for 5 pancakes, the pancake number is 5, which means there is a way to do all of them in 5 or fewer. So that wouldn't be necessarily the most efficient method. The nice thing about this is it actually originated from like a real world problem. So there was a mathematician, Jacob Goodman, who was trying to solve a problem in the real world. And this thing occurred to him as like, oh, that's an interesting puzzle. You know, how can I find how many flips it takes to do this? And he wasn't actually using pancakes at the time. It's really unfortunate. He wasn't in a kitchen, you know, cooking pancakes and discovered this. He had a stack of towels in the cupboard. It was a really domestic maths problem. And he had to try and put these towels in the cupboard, but he just had a shelf and there wasn't any kind of surface nearby. And he needed to change the order of the towels so he could just take the top of the stack and flip it over. And he kind of was like, oh, actually, that's quite a nice problem. And he wanted to write it up for a magazine, for American Mathematical Monthly. And he was like, oh, how can I reframe this so that it's a nice accessible thing? And this idea of using stacks of pancakes with a flipper was his way into this. He used a pseudonym. He wrote an article under the name of Harry Dwaiter, which is Harry Dwaiter, who's carrying the pancakes and so on. And it was, you know, it was a nice little, here's a problem. People responded to it and wrote back and stuff. So that was how the thing kind of first originated. But it's since it's become like a real thing and people work on it, people have published papers on it. So there's a chap called David Cohen who writes for The Simpsons, who's a mathematician, a computer scientist in his spare time when he's not writing for The Simpsons. I guess he trained as a computer scientist. And while he was studying, he also did a paper on this, which was on a thing called the burnt pancake problem. And in that case, you've got pancakes where one side of the pancake is burnt and you want to end up with them all in the right order in the stack, but also all the burnt sides down so that no one can tell that you've burnt all your pancakes on one side. And that makes it slightly more complex, and it means that you have to make sure that you do all the steps in the right order, and you might find that you've done it right, but they're all upside down and you need to redo the whole thing. So that's another thing that he's kind of published a paper on, and that's a separate but related problem, I guess.
You know, I'm glad you watch videos here on YouTube, but sometimes you want to go a bit deeper than these tempting nuggets of information we give you. And that's where the Great Courses Plus can come in. These on-demand videos can be entire lectures or entire courses full of videos taught to you by leading experts from around the world. There's a boat full of brilliant courses covering all sorts of mathematical subjects, of course. I've spoken about these before, I'm sure they'll appeal to Numberphile fans. But it's not just mathematics, you name it and they'll cover it. Sometimes when I'm just grazing on the Great Courses Plus, what I like to look at is geology and geography, things like this. Whatever your little niche interest, you can go really deep here on the Great Courses Plus. For a free 1 month trial, go to thegreatcoursesplus.com/numberphile. That's a free 1 month trial. There's the address on the screen, thegreatcoursesplus.com/numberphile. Give them a look. I'm sure you'll like them. And our thanks to them for supporting this video.